Welcome to this special holiday edition of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. I'm John Venere, and this is the chef, Sam Choy. And Uncle Sam.
Yes, John.
When you think holidays, whether it's...
Best time of the year.
Oh, yes, it is. But when you think holidays,
yes,
whether it's Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, or even a birthday in between,
right.
You think turkey.
I know. And you know, roasted, Hawaiian style, kalua in the oven, in the imu.
Yep.
And smoked, the latest thing.
Yeah.
Or even deboned and then rolled into a roll. Okay. Amazing.
Fried.
Fried. Oh, yes, fried. Yeah. But you know, the nice thing about that is all the sides that come with it.
Yes. And all those sides are some of my favorites and definitely some of Uncle Sam's favorites, which is why we're gifting you today in this holiday special some of Uncle Sam's favorite recipes from over the years.
That's right. It's very simple, but yet it's very good because people tell me, how did you make that? When I tell them, they look at me like, that's simple. I said, that's simple. So I'm going to share that with you folks today.
Yeah, so stick with us. Sit back. Enjoy. We've got turkey and all the stuff that goes with it on this episode of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. Let's get started. But what goes along well with the turkey?
The stuffing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Stuffing.
So a little butter, okay. Right? So we're going to walk this through because our viewers are going to see how we do it.
Yes. So we're John, gifting them your recipe.
Yes. So I got a little butter and a little bit of olive oil. Just got to make, you hold that bowl up right there. Put it right into the camera. Pour it into the camera.
Shaga.
Okay, saute that in there. Yeah, I got it. Okay, we're good, okay. And then, of course, John, add the carrots. Now, carrots I like because it has a little sweetness to it. Nice color, right?
Okay.
Now, just kind of saute that up.
Okay.
Kind of like a mirepoix. Yeah, you want to go ahead, John. Go ahead. John, you're just itching to grab
it. Did you just say a mirepoix?
Yep. Yeah, mirepoix, onion, celery, carrots, pretty much. That's a combo, right? Remember that.
Would you consider this a Christmas mirepoix?
Could be, but I call it a holiday mirepoix.
A holiday mirepoix.
Because...
Thank you, Samta.
Yeah, Samta. Hey, I like that. Hey, and then, of course, the celery. Kind of like, you know, important to have it kind of like not al dente, but little past al dente.
And a mirepoix is the base for what? A lot of stuff.
A lot of stuff. That's French cooking, mirepoix. Okay. Onion, celery, carrots, mirepoix. Okay, now I'm going to add some of Hawaii's best sausage.
Oh, buddy, sausage.
So normally you can add bacon, right? But we're going to use Portuguese sausage.
Okay. And you've done this a lot.
Oh, man. I've done it so many different ways. I've even added sweet potatoes and ulu in my stuffing. You know, so it's a variety of things, right?
But you're taking us back a couple decades to when you were a child.
Yeah, you know what I mean? That's the thing about, you know, cooking is like a guitar. So anyway, like a guitar, you got just the neck with all the boards there, all the keys.
The frets. The
frets, yeah. And unlimited amount of music can come out of that.
Okay.
Same like cooking. Right, a pot, some mirepoix, some Portuguese sausage. We're gonna add some spinach, right?
Spinach. This is a stuffing, right?
Yeah, stuffing.
Okay. All right, just making sure.
Yeah.
Don't stir it, we're just gonna let this steam down, right?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, we'll get it.
Okay, so what I wanna do at that moment, this moment here now, is add a little bit of stock.
Okay.
A little chicken. Stuffing mix here. This is the body of the stuffing.
There
as you can see in here, look how nice it's looking.
Yeah,
right?
It does look good.
Yeah, but you know, I'm gonna taste it because it's important to taste it.
Of course you're gonna taste it. No, that's a little too hot for me.
Perfect.
Ah!
Okay, now I'm gonna add the mixture. Now it has all the flavor. Okay,
so this is actually an easy thing because you're using it.
John, didn't I say we're gonna do easy things?
Yes, we're doing it easy. I know, I heard you say it.
So onion, celery, carrots, spinach, the veggies.
Okay.
And then Portuguese sausage, and then we use the stovetop stuffing, okay?
Yep, and then you added?
And I added the chicken stock. And I'm gonna add a little more, because I like it a little moist for me, because it'll dry up, okay? Okay, how's that? And we're done.
Stuffing's done.
Yeah, it's done. I'm gonna.
You're gonna taste it?
Yeah, I gotta taste it. Get the edges, John. Always important. Get the edges. So you guys see how easy it is. It's very easy, simple. Ah! Oh! Oh! Good.
Wow! Scared me for a minute.
Try it, John.
Oh.
Good, huh? See?
Ah!
Okay, we're done.
Stuffing's done.
Off the fire.
After the stuffing, now it's time for the...
fresh cranberry marmalade.
Ooh, okay, let's go.
So we got butter in the beginning.
Butter.
Sugar.
Sugar.
Caramelized it.
Caramelize it.
Not too dark, because right. You want to just have it just right. Then we had the cranberry, mm-hmm. A little cranberry jelly on the side that I mixed it in there with the fresh cranberries.
Okay.
And then I had the local orange, the Big Island orange, with our finger lime from my yard, yeah. Right? And then I had the zest from the orange.
Yeah, not the white part, just the brown
part. Just the brown part, yes. Okay, now we add some apples. Apples are great in this, okay? You know, so I've done this so many times that I've played around with it. I've had mint leaves in it.
Mm-hmm.
And when you do like a rack of lamb, this is amazing with the rack of lamb, like a mint jelly,
mm-hmm.
When you add the mint, the fresh mint from the yard. Okay, you see the moisture coming out? You know where that's coming from? That's from the cranberry, the fresh cranberry.
Ooh, okay,
look at that. Sad. Oh, man. Hot?
It looks it. Oh, boy.
Look at that. So, John, you can right now go into a bottle and jam it. You know, put it in ball bottles or mason jars.
Uh-huh.
Makes a great gift.
Of course, recipe will be on our website, k22.com, and you can follow us at Sam Choy's in the Kitchen.
Yes, and also we got an up-and-coming cookbook.
We do?
Yes, we do. Broke the news right now. Yes.
You're welcome, turkey, stuffing, cranberry marmalade, but we're not done. Next up?
Well, I'll tell you what, a gratin. It's kind of like a sweet potato gratin,
uh-huh.
And that's from just all the years of living in Hawaii, born and raised here.
Yeah.
Coconut milk infused into the food. So we're gonna do a gratin using coconut milk, not cream.
One of Sam's favorite childhood recipes.
Yeah.
You're welcome again.
Yeah.
Let's get started.
Like about 4 tablespoons of butter in there. Some nice local sweet potatoes that already been steamed. I'm gonna cut them out just like that, right? Look at this, guys.
So you steamed them.
Yeah, so it's solid.
Got them ready.
Yeah. Then we're gonna just put them right in our pan. We're gonna line it up just like that.
And you're putting marshmallows, we have brown sugar, and we have coconut milk.
Right. Okay, so kind of like just like that.
How old were you when you first had this?
Oh man, my mom used to make this a lot. When I was like, before high school.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay, so the butter.
Okay, so you see how it looks like, so can you hear the butter going?
Yes.
So the butter's going right now, okay? Got a coconut milk in there. I'm gonna add the brown sugar right into it.
Okay.
Got a big spoon right there.
Brown sugar in the coconut milk.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now I'm gonna go right
just
into
right
here.
On top.
Just like that, right in the middle.
Right in the middle.
Yeah.
You know, coconut milk and brown sugar.
Yeah.
Oh man, okay. So you're boiling it all over again.
Yeah, right, yeah, look at that. Oh, man. Look at that.
We let it simmer.
Yeah.
And we let it kind of reduce a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. It smells amazing.
It does.
You know?
It does. I'm looking forward to it.
And then,
you have a bowl of marshmallows.
Yeah. Put it all.
Why not?
I'm so glad it's... The sugar is free to you, John, in here. Help yourself.
The what?
The sugar.
No, no, no.
It's fat-free and sugar-free.
Yeah. Wait, the sugar is sugar-free?
Yeah.
Interesting.
No, it's free to you, the sugar.
Oh, my God.
Just a little
These
bit.
These are some great dishes.
Well, you know, it's different. You know, I mean, that's important in cooking, right? You can only eat the same things over and over and over. And after a while, you want to eat something different.
And we're not done because we're going to be doing different here momentarily with pork.
Yeah.
Ooh, awesome. Can't wait for us to start that. Yeah. It's starting to just smush like an icing almost.
Yeah.
Nice.
Sam Choi's in the Kitchen. Hotel accommodations provided by Ala Moana Hotel.
Welcome back to this special edition of Sam Choi's in the Kitchen. We are cooking it up today, Uncle
That's
Sam.
That's right. But it's a holiday menu.
Ooh, I love it. And when you think menu.
Yeah.
Main dish, most of the time you think ham.
Right. because it's a great combo, right? Turkey, mm-hmm. ham, automatic.
But we're doing something different.
That's right. We're doing a boneless pork loin stuffed. Seasoned, roasted in the oven.
Tie it all up
in the oven. When it comes out, nice marmalade on the top. Let it cool down because it's important to let it rest. Mm-hmm. Then slice it down. Amazing.
All right, really, we're going to give it to you right now. Let's get started.
If you take notice, this is kind of like how you get the boneless pork loin.
Okay.
Like this.
And then what'd you do to it?
And I just kind of butterflied it, did a little simple butterfly.
Okay.
See, like that, right?
Okay.
You'd get it like that, right?
Right.
And then at some of the other stores, you got the whole loin. We just got a little 3-pounder.
Okay.
And you just kind of like butterfly and just kind of like unravel it like that. Okay.
Good trick.
Yeah. And then I like to rub a little bit, just a little bit of olive oil.
Okay.
Just a little bit. You know, I like to just layer flavors. You know, I mean, that's what makes food exciting. You know?
Yeah, well, you're going to get it in there. You're going to rub it in there.
Yeah, and a little season, a little that kind of seasoned salt.
Okay.
Okay, just a little bit. Okay. And I guess this is another trick I do.
Ooh.
It's a little bit of the marmalade.
What is this marmalade?
It's an orange marmalade. You could use a cranberry too, but
okay.
I like to just do a little bit of that.
Orange marmalade.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I got that. Yeah. I like that.
It is, it's a great.
Now you said it's stuffed, so we have a little bit of the stuffing that we put outside.
Yeah. So you're gonna stuff it right now. Tuck it in like this.
You're tucking it in.
Mm-hmm.
Now that's why you're saying sushi, like sushi. Yeah. You're doing it exactly like a sushi roll.
Yeah, keep it all in there though.
Yep. Okay, one more roll.
One more roll, and then you're right back to the top. Okay?
Now. I got to tie it.
They, you know, I did this like, you know, tying it like 40 years ago, John.
40 years ago?
Oh yeah, I used to do turkeys, chicken, all these great things, you know. But just do a little, tie it tight like that, you know. And then just do another knot right in here.
Okay.
And then that locks it right in there. And then you kind of like just do this right here like this, look, like that.
A trick.
Yeah.
I like it.
So just make sure you get the spaces evenly, right?
I like the way you just stick your finger right in there and just pick it up.
So you see it like that, John? Mm-hmm. So you're just lining it all up. It's a real great way to tie things down. Instead of, you know, like going individually, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then you do again, right? You go underneath here again, you just slide it up. Okay?
Do you have to keep going from that side?
Yeah, you go all the way that way. Come on, John.
Okay, yes. Yep.
I'm teaching you the best way. You pull it all that way, you go right back like that, right?
You're squeezing the stuffing out of the pork loin.
Am I?
Yeah.
So we're gonna put that right back in there.
Just shove it in.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay, so we go right back in there.
Okay.
All the way back to that top. Okay, John, you got that?
Yep.
The key to this, John, is making it snug. Okay?
Okay.
So when you make it snug, you cook it perfectly evenly. Okay? Yeah, so John, the reason why we're putting a bed of these, the mirepoix,
mm-hmm.
because when you roast the pork loin,
okay.
you're gonna get a lot of juices coming out, and that's how you make your pan gravy. Right there like that. So then you grab a nice loin like this.
Fat side up or down?
Upside up like that, right there. Okay, so now where's our seasoned duck hind? Oh no, before I do the hind, I'm gonna just add a little more love up here.
Oh, right on top.
Yeah.
Shoots.
Just a little marmalade. Whew! And then of course our salt, just a little bit. Okay, so that goes right in a 350 oven for about maybe an hour and 10 minutes.
Really?
Yeah. Hams are great, but sometimes it's good to change, right?
I'm thinking that's really good to
change. That is very good to change.
Good job.
A stuffed roast pork loin.
All great holiday meals have to have a smattering of desserts.
That's the dangerous part.
Oh, but there's always one that you want to serve. First and foremost, it's the focal dessert.
Dessert, yeah.
And today we're doing the most Googled dessert. When you search dessert for Sam Choy, it's the
pumpkin crunch.
Pumpkin crunch, I love it.
Hey, you know, I gotta admit to this story, John. One time I got a lady call me up, that pumpkin crunch is amazing. I said, Yeah, but you know, I didn't create that. Okay. But I did it one time and somebody took that recipe in one of my many occasions of cooking classes and they put it out there and boy, it's been really big.
And we're sharing it with all of you.
Yes, pumpkin crunch, which is a very famous thing in Hawaii. A lot of people do that.
I can't wait.
You kind of just do a little flip-flop right there. Oh, not, be careful now.
There you go.
When you're making pumpkin crunch, it's important to get this done.
Okay.
And this is your cake mix. And we got the, you can also use fresh pumpkin. Roast it in the oven, crush it out. Little cinnamon in.
Okay. That's exactly how I said it when I was a kid.
Yeah. Sugar.
We're making pumpkin crunch.
Yeah. Eggs. John, stir a little bit, please. Okay, go.
How do you know when?
When, just keep going. I like pumpkin pie.
Yeah.
You know, so let me just get a little taste in there.
Okay, dump. So we're gonna put this in?
Right in the middle, dump it in the middle.
Dump it in the middle.
High, go high. You always go high.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Why do you have to do that to me?
Hey John, try this, it's really good.
Yeah, that's a drop the mic type moment. This is the yellow cake mix.
Yeah, and you just wanna cover it all over this, the whole cake.
Okay.
If you like pumpkin pie, to yes. me, this is really good.
You know, I never used to like pumpkin pie until I actually ate it. Good job, Uncle Sam. Okay. So what's the cooking instructions? We're not done.
Yeah, 45 minutes.
You melted butter.
Yeah, melted batter. That's
now
the,
what?
That's the crust.
This is actually easier than doing like the whole cake
batter. Yeah, this is, I think that's why people have really took a liking to this. And you know, it was pretty much that's it. You don't want to go too much more.
This is like, this is a drop the mic moment.
Yeah, wait till you eat it. You're gonna go like, yeah,
I can't wait. All of this goes really well with Clos du Bois, I gotta tell you. Man. Cheers to an unbelievable meal.
Well, holiday.
There you go. Let's recap what we did.
Well, first we did the stuffing. Real simple, mirepoix.
Yep.
Onion, celery, carrots, sauteed it up with a little butter and olive oil, sauteed that up. Added a little stock to it, added spinach. Just kind of got it nice and moist, al dente. Added some chicken stock, there it was.
Awesome.
Went right in the oven, kept it nice and hot. And then of course we did the, after that we did the cranberry.
Yep.
Cranberry was very simple.
Now I don't normally eat cranberries, but I just want to tell you, I really like this.
Yeah, Big Island oranges. Took the rind out, sliced it real thin. Finger limes, apple. Fresh cranberry, little cranberry jelly. Mm-hmm. Put it right in that, and boy, let me tell you what, it was just so simple. Cook it down like a jam, really nice.
Super good.
Yep, and then after that, we did the yams. Steamed the yam off first, yep. Then sliced it, peeled it. Coconut milk, brown sugar, and butter.
Marshmallows.
Marshmallows on the top, let it reduce
so
down.
So good, Uncle Sam.
Yeah, very good. And then, of course, we did our stuffed pork loin roast. Little marmalade, little seasoning, some duck kind seasoning on it.
Yeah.
And then turn around, we tied it all up. 350, about an hour, 45 to an hour. Cool down, slice it, took the jus, the drippings, made an au jus right over the top. That was it. And pumpkin crunch.
Another good one.
You gotta try the pumpkin crunch.
I just wanna say thank you for, you know, we're going on almost the end of season 8. It's just been a wonderful run.
Yeah.
Learning from you, cooking with you, getting to hang out with you. It's been an amazing run, so thank you so much. Here's to however many more years they let us do it.
We're gonna go as long as we can. Because you guys make us do it. We love it. Thank you guys so much for watching.
Absolutely. Thank you to all the viewers that that help us keep do all
going.
The things that we do to keep us going, that send us in comments, allow us to come cook at your homes. Keep all those requests coming.
Yes.
We plan on hitting it hard.
That's right. Next season going to be unreal.
Yeah.
We're bringing our A game.
But remember,
when Sam Choy's in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Happy holidays. Cheers.
Chef Sam Choy. No, come on. Please come my house, look my icebox. Our food is complimentary. And please bring John Canary.
I gotta get some course there. Okay, so when you're making pumpkin punch. When you're making pumpkin crunch, it's important to get this done.
Okay.
And this is your cake mix. And we got the, you can also use fresh pumpkin. Roast it in the oven, crush it up, little cinnamon.
Okay.